The history of the present complex of schools in central Westville began in March of 1935, when Miss Carr opened the doors of her little private school to 6 pupils, 4 boys and 2 girls. It was housed in a hall on the present site of the Westville Fire Station and Clinic. To quote Miss Carr, "It was not the ideal place by any means, as there was no water laid on and there were only pit toilets, but we overcame these and many other difficulties as they cropped up. The days were far from dull. One day a mamba took up residence in the cloakroom, much to everyone's horror, and help had to be sought. On another occasion, a plague of fleas moved in, and lessons for the day came to an abrupt halt, much to the delight of the young pupils." By 1941, the school had outgrown its accommodation, and a move was made to an old house situated on the present Westville Boys High School site. Again to quote Miss Carr, "There was still a happy country atmosphere, as the children came to school on horses and donkeys. At that time, lessons didn't start until all the pupils were at school. Considering the mode of transport, the start of the school day varied considerably. It was a government-aided school, and the annual school fees were the equivalent of 1 rand and 25 cents. The school grew rapidly, and by 1955, following extensions and improvements to the school buildings, foundations were laid for high school status. Apparently, despite not having access to a science laboratory, the class that wrote the external junior certificate examinations that year obtained results which exceeded the highest expectations and set a pattern of outstanding results which has been followed ever since. In 1957, with the number of pupils at 790, Class 1 to Standard 8, that's present Grade 10, a separate junior school, Westville Senior Primary School, was built, and 258 pupils transferred to that school. The school was to continue as a high school for both boys and girls until 1964, when our school was built, and girls from Standard 6, 7 and 9 were transferred. The girls from Standard 8 and Standard 10, your present Grade 12, finished their studies at Westville Boys High School due to them writing public examinations at the end of that year. And so began our school's specific history. Westville in those days was still very much a rural area, with residential development taking place on what was generally small holdings farmed by Indians. On the area now occupied by the Girls High School was a market gardener from whom vegetables and fruit could be purchased. Westville Girls High School opened in January 1964 with only 9 classrooms. The headmistress's office was in the sick bay. The vice principal and secretary shared the marking room, and there was a staff room. Phenomenal growth regarding the facilities began in 1965 and has continued to the present. Between 1965 and 1973, the hall, tennis courts, swimming pool, gym, and lecture theatre were added. The addition of the swimming pool in 1971 was a great celebration for us, as up until then we had to walk to the Westville swimming pool for our PE lessons. We sought out as many shortcuts through people's gardens as possible in order to avoid the wrath of the PE teacher who would give us the royal wave as she drove past in her car. At Westville Girls High, much has changed, but at the same time, much has remained the same. Certainly, there has been significant changes in the infrastructure of the school over the years. The development of our educational facilities has provided for past and present learners an environment in which highly effective teaching and learning is able to take place. It is largely the involvement and contribution of those who came before to which we are grateful. They have left a legacy that you and I benefit greatly from in the present. The music studio, drama and art studios, our magnificent library, the science labs, computer wing, the AstroTurf, the MJC and cafeteria. This is a dynamic school, never static. And Westville Girls High has never deviated from its pursuit of excellence. Westville Girls High has always remained steadfast in its fundamental objectives of educational, personal, and social development of its pupils. Throughout its history, Westville Girls High has had distinctive, highly effective characteristics that remain embodied in the ethos of our school to this day. We have a number of old girls at the school on the staff presently. Mrs. Spinelli, Miss Jacobs, Mrs. Schumann, Miss Yates, Miss Martin, Mrs. Kutsier, Miss Pillay, Miss Bernhardt, and Mrs. Pollard. Two other really old girls are Mrs. Bovey and Mrs. Fuller. The three of us, that is Mrs. Johnson, Mrs. Bovey, and Mrs. Fuller, were in the same class from grade 8 to matric. Much of what we see around us on a daily basis is very familiar, but there are some changes that may be of interest to you. For example, the uniform. It hasn't changed much, but in our day, the shirt was buttoned up right to the top button, and it was a real concession on hot days to undo it. Our skirts had box pleats. We wore lace-up shoes and we thought we were so grown up. We had to wear stockings in winter, but in those days it was with suspender belts. There were no such things as pantyhose, and these were for seniors only. In winter we wore a felt hat, and in summer a Panama hat, and there was no such thing as long pants. Athletics was unheard of, as it was deemed to be unladylike. It only began in our final year of school. The PE uniform has changed quite dramatically. In our day, we wore double-breasted navy blue tunic with enormous blue bloomers. Transport was mostly on foot, and some girls would come to school on bicycles. The matric dance was held in the civic centre, and the frocks worn by the learners were often made by themselves or their mothers. At the inter-school gala, our school was the first school to sing and have war cries, while the other schools clapped politely. Our bags consisted of suitcases made of cardboard or briefcases. And then, of course, there was the truant officer. If you were away from school and there was suspicion that it was not because you were sick, the education department would be phoned and a truant officer would be duly dispatched to your home. When I began my teaching career in 1978, we were an all-female staff, but that was to change over the years. According to a directive issued to teachers in 1904, teachers were not to dress in bright colours, were not to marry or keep company with men during their employment. They were not to get into an automobile with any man except a brother or father, and were not to loiter at ice cream stores. Although during my early teaching years, we certainly were not expected to comply with these criteria, we were expected to wear frocks with sleeves, petticoats, closed court shoes and stockings, and if we wished to wear trousers, it had to be a matching slack suit. Thankfully, times have changed. I do need to mention a time of great celebration that opened up a whole new and exciting dimension at Westville Girls High School. That was the opening up of the school to all races in 1991. The following was recorded in the school magazine of that year. 1991 has been a happy year, enriched by cross-cultural exchanges. This simple description of that year is a testament to how Westville Girls High has always embraced change in a positive and welcoming manner. Despite the many changes and challenges that have confronted Westville Girls High, our core value system has always remained constant. Each one of you learners are the history makers of Westville Girls High School. You will leave a legacy for the future. Each one of you has something to contribute. Each person is unique. It is the people who have made our school what it is. If you are serious about making a significant contribution, whatever direction you choose, do not resist challenges, nor struggle to cope with and adjust to these challenges, but determine to become a proactive part of school life by committing yourself to the process of shaping and determining the future of your school.